Follow me for the installation of Nodal Red. Nodal Red actually is not at the moment on the download page, so you will need to go to Discord, which is on the homepage of the project. You simply need to accept the invite and to connect to Discord. And then if you look into the folder named R2X support, you get some pinned comments and you should find the download links for Nodal Red. So simply click on that and then choose your preferred version. You will have a Linux version, Mac OS version, and Windows as well. I'm choosing the Mac OS version and the audio unit. So just click and save it everywhere you like. And after downloading, you simply need to unzip the file. And then you will need to manually copy the component file into your component folder for Logic to work and to recognize the plugin. So simply open another Finder window and then click on Go to Folder, choose Library, and then choose Audio, then choose Plugin, and then select Components, and simply drag and drop the component file into your Components folder. And your Mac will probably ask you for the password, so simply insert your password. You will also put the firmware files for the Nodal Red 2X into the same components folder, but it's not legal to share them, so I'm not giving you any link. But if you just Google around a little bit, you can probably find something. Just have a look at this video and try to guess where you can find the firmware, okay? On Windows, you shouldn't have any problem loading the plugin, but at least on Mac, the binaries for the plugin are not verified by the operating system, and so you will not be able to load them. And you see, you get an error if you try to load the plugin and the plugin is completely blank if you try to open it. But luckily, there are a couple of easy fixes to be able to load the plugin. And the first fix is just to execute the command file that is in the zip for the plugin. But unluckily, in my computer, it didn't work, so I had to do something else. And the second fix is just to manually execute a script, like in the video. I will give you a description and a copy and paste solution in the description. So you simply execute this and then the plugin should work. And now the plugin should work and load without any kind of issue. So you simply select it and open it. And as you can see, the plugin is not working, so simply open it. And then you will need to add some patches because they are not in the firmware, so just have a look at the video here.